Good morning, students. Today we are going to see A Trip to Bhopal, Chapter 3, the remaining exercise. See, now the children are going to their lunch time. So there is a conversation. See here, the children are hungry by this time, so they take out their lunch bags. Biscuits, orange and bananas are also distributed in all the buses. So in all the buses, they are distributing biscuits, bananas and the oranges. See, each child is to be given one orange, one banana and five biscuits. So for each child, how many oranges are given? Only one orange and one banana, and biscuits count is five. Anju biscuit vandute kudukuraanga. Next, all the children take oranges and biscuits, but 38 children do not take bananas. Okay, so all the children are taking biscuits and oranges, but 38 children mattu bananas vandute eduthukave illa. So now the question is, how many oranges, biscuits and bananas are distributed? Appo evlo oranges, biscuits and bananas vandute distribute pannirpaanga. So for this you have to know how much student are going to the trip. So this you already know, previous videos paathirundinga therinjirukku. So total how many number of students are going to the trip? So it is 210. So total are 210 students vandute. So students going to the trip. So students going to the trip count vandute 210. So oranges and bananas and other biscuits vandute ella students ume distribute pandranga. So for each student, how many oranges are distributed? Only one. Appo question enna ketirukanga, how many oranges are distributed? Appo kandipa evlo oranges distribute panirpaanga? 210 oranges distribute panirpaanga. So count of orange distributed is equal to 210. So 210 students trip ku poirukanga. So ellathukume oranges distribute panirukanga, because for each student only one oranges vandu kudukuraanga. Appo 210 students ku 210 oranges vandu ovvorukku ovvor oranges poga 210 oranges vandu distribute panirukanga. Next you see biscuits. How many biscuits are distributed? See here, biscuits vandu or student ku evlo kudukuraanga? 5. So one student ku 5 biscuits kudukuraanga. Total how many students are going to the trip? 210. So one student ku 5 biscuits na 210 students ku evlo biscuits vandute distribute panirpaanga kada question. So for this you have to multiply 5 and 210. So one too many, or item kudutittu neraya evlo ketalo, so for this you use the multiplication operation. So count of biscuits distributed, count of biscuits distributed is equal to, you simply multiply 5 and 210. In the 5 appadiyirudhu, for each student they are giving 5 biscuits, and 210 appadiyirudhu total number of students. So you simply multiply 5 and 210. So multiply panna enna varum? 210 into 5, so 0, 15s are 5, 52s are 10. So 1050. So 1050 biscuits vandute distribute pannirupanga. So next you come to the third question. How many bananas are distributed? Evlo bananas vandute distribute pannirupanga? See here, 38 children do not take banana. Appo 38 children vandute banana vandute eduthukave illa. So for this, what you have to do means you simply subtract 38 from 210. இது 38 வந்துட்டு 210 ல இருந்து சப்ராக்ஷன் பண்ணணும். ஹவு மீன்ஸ், 210 வந்துட்டு டோட்டல் நம்பர் ஆஃப் சில்ட்ரன், அதில் 38 மெம்பர்ஸ் வந்துட்டு பனானா வந்துட்டு எடுத்துக்கவே இல்லை. நவ் த க்வெஸ்சன் இஸ், ஹவு மெனி பனானாஸ் ஆர் டிஸ்ட்ரிபியூட்டட்? ஸோ இது தவிர, இந்த 38 இருக்கிறத தவிர மீதி இருக்கிறவங்களுக்கு தான் பனானாஸ் டிஸ்ட்ரிபியூட் பண்ணியிருப்பாங்க. ஸோ ஃபார் திஸ் யூ சிம்ப்ளி சப்ராக்ட் 38. யார் யாருக்கு பனானா வேண்டாமோ அவங்கள வந்துட்டு டோட்டல் நம்பர் ஆஃப் ஸ்டூடெண்ட்லேருந்து சப்ராக்ஷன் பண்ணணும். ஸோ யூ சப்ராக்ட், வாட் வில் யூ கெட்? சி ஹியர் இட் இஸ் 0, யூ ஹாவ் டு பாரோ ஒன் தி, here it is 10. So 8, so see here 10, so when you subtract 8 from 10 you will get 2. See here it is 0, now you borrow 1. here it will become 10. So when you subtract 3 from 10, you will get 7. Now you put down 1. So 172 bananas vandu distribute panirupanga. So total 210 children irukanga. Adula 38 members ku vandu bananas vendam. Appa micha irukravulukku dhaan the bananas distribute panirupanga. So adula vandu evlo students balance irukanga? 172. So now count of banana distributed is equal to bananas distribute panirupanga count 172. So that means you simply write 210 minus 38. So you will get 172. So have you understand? So from the given information, for each student, one orange, one banana, and 5 biscuits are distributed. So the main thing is 38 children do not take bananas. These two are the given information. So from the given information, what is the question asked is how many oranges, biscuits and bananas are distributed. So for each children, how many orange? One orange is distributed. And for 210 children are going to the trip. And for 210 children, 210 oranges are distributed. Now the count of the biscuits. So for each student, how many biscuits are given? 5 biscuits are given. So for 210 students, you simply multiply 5 and 210, you will get 1050. So 1050 biscuits on the distribute panirupanga. The next one is the count of banana distributed. So for this, you simply subtract 38 from 210. Reason enna na 38 students ku vandu the children ku vandu bananas vandu vendan solittanga appo meedam irukkaradhu da kuduthirupanga. So and the 210 total count of children la irundha the 38 student vendan sonnavanga subtraction pannum bolude namakku 172 pa 172 children ku vandu bananas distribute pannirupanga. Have you understand this? Shall we move on to the next concept? So here you have learned the multiplication and the subtraction. So shall we move on to the next concept? The next thing is Manjit and Banu quickly finish their lunch and start asking puzzles to pass the time. So what the children are doing is they are asking some puzzles during their lunch period. See, Manjit is tell me the number which is exactly between 100 and 150. So idu vandu Manjithoda puzzle. What is he is saying is what is the exact number between 100 and 150? Adhaavadhu 100 ku 150 ku exact ah middle la vandu enna number irukku appdin solittu Manjithoda question. So now we can solve this question. Before this you see the simplest form. See, here I have taken two numbers, one is 10 and another one is 20. Now I have to find the middle number between 10 and 20. So 10 ku 20 ku middle vandu enna varum abdingada na vandu find out pananum. So first you write the numbers after 10. So what are the numbers? 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. You will know, you need not include 20 because 10 ல இருந்து 10 க்கு 20 க்கு மிடில் இருந்து வந்து இந்த நம்பர்ஸ் தான் இதுல எக்ஸாக்ட்டா கரெக்ட்ட பிட்வீன்ல வந்து 10 க்கு 20 க்கு மிடில்ல லை ஆயிருக்க நம்பர்ஸ் வந்து. So now which number is exactly between 100 and 150? So 100 ku 150 ku exact in between iruka number enna nu solittu kekkranga. So before going to this, you see this is a simple example. You have here we are going to find the number exactly between 10 and 20. For this you simply write the numbers lying between 10 and 20. So the numbers are 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18 and 19. See here, this is first number, second number, third, fourth, and here it is 1, 2, 3, 4. So the exact number lying between 10 and 20 is 15. So 15 is the number that is the lying between 10 and 20. So 10 ku 20 ku nadula exacta iruka middle number edhu appadina 15 nama sollalam. So this is easy because 10 to 20 appadina bodhu nama neeta eludhi nama count numbers vandu kammi lesser irukkaatti nama eludhi nama kandupidichiruvom. Suppose if it is a big number means it is not possible to write all these numbers. So for this you simply add the given two numbers. So first in the two numbers nadula middle number kekkraangalo and the two numbers add pannirukonga. For this you simply add the given two numbers. Here they are asking to find the middle number between 10 and 20. So simply add 10 and 20. 10 plus 20 and divided by 2. So what is the answer? 10, if you add 10 and 20 you will get 30, and if you divide it by 2 you will get 15. So now we get the exact answer. So 15 is the number lying between 10 and 20. So have you understood? So numbers eludiyum nama vandu find out pannalam, but in case of large numbers means it is so difficult. So numbers are eludittirukka mudiyadhu. So for this you simply add the numbers and you divide it by 2. So here what is the question is, which number is exactly between 100 and 150? So 100 ku 150 ku nadula exact ah iruka middle number enna nu kekkranga. So simply add 100 and 150. So what you will get, you will get 650, right? And 250. So you simply divide 250 by 2. So 252. So 1 times 2, when you subtract you will get 0, and you bring 5, so 2 2s are 4, and you subtract you will get 1, and you bring down 0, so 5, 5 2s are 10. So now your remainder is 0. So what is my answer? 125. So 125 is the exact number lying between 10 and 150. Nee idu doubt ah irundha appadina you may also write those numbers in the literally. So 100 101, so starting from 101 102 103 appdin solittu 149 varaiku neenga eludite exact ah middle number count panni pathinginalo inga 125 vandu varum. So it is a long term process. So for this you simply add the given two numbers. எந்த ரெண்டு நம்பர்ஸ்க்கு நடுவுல மிடில் நம்பர் ஃபைண்ட் அவுட் பண்ண சொல்லியிருக்காங்களோ அது ரெண்டு நம்பர்ஸை ஆட் பண்ணி 2 ஆல் டிவைட் பண்ணிட்டீங்கன்னா யூ வில் கெட் த எக்ஸாக்ட் மிடில் நம்பர். So see here the puzzle number A. I have 4 toffees, each to 4 of my friends, and 3 toffees are left with me. How many toffees did I have? So again read the question. I gave 4 toffees each to 4 of my friends. So now you are giving 4 toffees. Toffees means what? Chocolate. So 4 toffees vandu 4 friends ku kudukringa. So remaining 3 toffees are left with me. Remaining evlo toffees un kaiyila irukku appadina 3 toffees vandu irukke. So total ah evlo toffees vandu friends kitta kudukkuradhukku munnadi irundhirukku. That is the question. How many toffees did I have? So see here, how many friends are there? 4 friends. So how many friends? 4 friends. So for each friend, how many toffees are given? 4 toffees. So for each friend, 4 toffees are, 4 toffees you are giving. So one friend ku vandu 4 toffees neenga kudukringa. For 4 friends, how many toffees you should give? 4 into 4. So you get 16. Okay. So 4 friends irukanga. Ovvoru friend ku 4 toffees odru kudukranga. So for 1 friend, 4 toffees. So for 4 friend, how many toffees? 4 into 4, 16 toffees. So now remaining 16 kudutadhu poga remaining how many you are having? 3. So the remaining toffees you are having is 3. Remaining toffees you are having in your hand, how many? 3. So now the question is, how many toffees did I have? அதாவது இனிஷியலா என்கிட்ட எவ்வளவு டாஃபீஸ் இருக்கோ. சோ இ சிம்பிளி ஆட் 16 அண்ட் 13. சோ ரிமைனிங் டாஃபீஸ் இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு டாஃபீஸ் ஐ ஹேட் இனிஷியலி. இனிஷியலா என்கிட்ட, அதாவது முன்னாடி என்கிட்ட எவ்வளவு டாஃபீஸ் இருந்திருக்கோ, இ சிம்பிளி ஆட் 16 அண்ட் 3. சோ டோட்டலி 19 டாஃபீஸ் என்கிட்ட இருந்திருக்கோ. ஹேவ் யூ அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட்? So, 4 friends irukanga. For each friend, you are giving 4 toffees. So, for 1 friend, we are giving 4 toffees. And for 4 friend, you are giving 16 toffees. So, 16 toffees kuduthinga. So, and the 16 toffees kuduthadhu poga remaining you are having 3 toffees in your hand. So now the question is how many toffees did I have? Adhaavadhu initially engitta first kudukkuradhukku munadi evlo toffees irundhirukku. So for this you simply add the 16 toffees and 3 toffees left out. So 16 plus 3 is 19. So totally you have 19 toffees initially. And 19 toffees la 16 toffees vandu friends kuduthadhu poga mitch 3 toffees vandu remaining irukku. So I hope you have understood. So based on this, some simple homework sums are given to you through WhatsApp. If you have any doubt regarding this video, ask me through WhatsApp. Thank you.